before we get started. During my last show, someone was on their laptop, somebody answered a phone call, someone was on Snapchat, somebody was texting the whole time, someone was playing video games. Please turn off your stuff, and if you're gonna take pictures, don't use Flash, please, because it distracts people behind you and in front of you.
We are funded by UPAC, but we rely mostly on donations, so please consider donating during the intermission. And we'll also have concessions during intermission, and they will be sold by a cast member in character.
Or a couple of cast members.
Or three.
They're still figuring it out. And the show runs about an hour and 50 minutes, including a 10-minute intermission. I present Bill.
Well,
you're annoyed.
A little bit, yeah. We didn't know who else to call. It's fine. You've hardly said a word. Faith? Well, how did you get my number? I've tried calling you before, but I couldn't get through. Figured you changed your number or something.
I looked you up when I moved here.
And you didn't call sooner?
Wasn't sure what to say. It's been a while.
Yeah, reuniting in county jail was a great welcome back. Don't get me wrong, I'm glad you called. It's just, I didn't think it'd be so...
Sorry.
So...
What?
When did you...
When did I?
That guy.
What about him?
How long have you known him?
A year.
Why?
Why what?
Why him?
I love him.
Are you serious?
Yeah.
Please, he has enough piercings to be a carnival attraction.
So?
And more ink on his body,
that's what people do.
He set you up. So why him?
I like him.
A minute ago, I mean just a second ago,
stop.
You told me you loved him. Wait, I just don't get it.
Beatrice, you don't know him. You just saw him. That's it. If you knew him the way I do, then yeah, maybe I knew he was doing something wrong. But when you're crazy about someone, you let the gut feeling come first and the rational reason come later.
My God, you can't even pretend you're not pissed at him.
What? He set you up.
Back off.
No one set me up.
I don't know what else to call it.
Call it a mistake and drop it.
A mistake?
He forgot.
You don't just forget that you left cocaine.
I didn't know.
Obviously you didn't know.
How the heck did you
get... Fuck off. What is going on?
What's with the interrogation? Jesus Christ.
Okay. You're right. I'm sorry. I just want to know everything. I mean, besides this, what have you been up to?
I'll write you a letter.
No, cut the crap! You had all that time to write me a letter, and you never did. And I think that I deserve, I don't know, a little more than this after what you put me through tonight.
I grew up.
So have I.
What else?
Last I heard from you was halfway through college. I called your aunt, and she said you just left?
Yeah.
Well, I think she deserves more than a piece of notebook paper saying you're leaving. Don't you think she deserved, I don't know, a thank you?
For what?
She took you in! And what about me, Faith? I mean, you never wrote me a letter, an email, a stupid text message.
Look, I thought about calling. I moved on.
Why didn't you? Was it just easier to forget us all?
Yes! Yes, it was, okay? I'm sorry if that hurts.
I just don't understand. I mean, I can't understand. You made me stick with Girl Scouts for so long, and I hated selling Thin Mint cookies at 6 a.m. outside of Home Depot on Saturday? What is that? And we played flute together, and we played soccer, and we had blockbusters.
I thought about calling you.
And why didn't
just
you?
Just stop.
Faith!
Look, I have a lot to tell you. It's just a lot to sort out right now, okay? I didn't think that I would be seeing you. I wasn't planning
on... Wasn't planning on cocaine, huh?
Wasn't planning on drugs. I could tell that guy was a junkie after 2 minutes.
And I bet you knew it, too. And what, you expect me to believe that's mascara?
Couples fight.
With words, Faith, not with faith.
No play on blast. I was being really selfish about something. I started to yell at... I don't know.
And he asked you to take his backpack to his friend's
house? I had to. He had his license revoked 2 weeks ago.
Oh my God, you're not helping your case.
What case? I didn't ask for your help.
Yeah, you kind of did when you decided to call me.
It was late. I was alone. I was scared. Beatrice, I was in jail. I didn't know who else to call.
None of your other friends?
Oh my God.
Please tell me you have other friends. A neighbor. Anyone at all.
You called me.
7 years is a long, long time, Faith. I mean, where did you go?
Just anywhere.
This isn't really the best fresh start.
I know.
And you know what else they told me down at the station?
What? What are you doing?
That is mine!
What is that? What's in it?
Oh, look at that!
I like art.
Gee, I wonder what kind.
It's illegal.
It's illegal.
Only if you get caught.
And did you?
Once.
Great, that's awesome. That's really responsible.
Sorry.
I've been taking placement exams
to get into med school.
Still trying to be a doctor, just a nurse right now. And I'm living out of my grandmother's old house. She died a while back.
Okay.
You're not going back, right?
Back?
Back to him.
He's in jail.
I know, but you're leaving him, right?
I've never stayed with someone so long.
You stayed with your aunt for a while.
Yeah, I know.
She waited for you to come back.
I did. I came back 3 months ago. She moved.
Too many memories, I thought.
So here I am.
Well, just stay here tonight. I don't want you going back to his place. At least not now. I don't know your life. At least not this part of it. But I was your best friend once.
Still am, maybe.
Wait here. I've got something for you.
What?
I didn't think I'd actually see you to give it to you.
What?
A letter.
From who?
Your dad. I know you probably don't want it, but here.
I've got my court hearing tomorrow.
Just stay here tonight, then.
Sorry.
Hey, it's fine. I mean, you just got caught up in the wrong crowd is all, right? We all make mistakes. We can catch up more tomorrow. I've got to head to bed. Are you coming?
Yeah, I'll be in a minute. Don't wait up.
Okay. Hey, it's nice seeing you again. I mean it.
Hi!
How do you do?
Fucking terrible.
I'm sorry.
Did you send my summons for jury duty?
No.
Then don't be sorry. I just came over here because it looked like you were having a worse day than me.
I'm fine.
That's a lie.
Excuse me?
You've been staring at the same tree for an hour, frowning. Something's wrong.
Are you a therapist?
No, philosopher.
Yeah, how does that pay?
It pays me with peace of mind.
Oh, so you're homeless?
If you mean what I do for a living, I flip burgers down at Greasy Days. So, what do you do exactly?
I'm in between jobs.
Is that so?
Who the hell are you?
Where are my manners, huh? Dominic, mad to meet you.
Don't you mean glad?
Well, if I were glad and you were glad, I wouldn't have met you.
Right.
And what should I call you, miss?
Don't call me miss.
What should I call you then?
Faith, how do you do?
I've already been over this. I'm mad about going to court in a month.
You're weird, Dominic.
That's rather presumptuous.
Sorry.
Don't be, I am weird. All of the greatest minds are.
Philosophers.
Every day, we have hundreds of disconnected thoughts. We can go days at a time, even months, before we can think of something meaningful. And some people just ignore those meaningful thoughts. And I think it's our duty to share them.
Yeah, well, maybe people don't share them because it's no one else's damn business.
Writers do that all the time. When Emily Dickinson and Langston Hughes published their thoughts into books, people from all times and places got to read their deep and personal thoughts. Virginia Woolf practically had a suicide note published in the preface to Between the Acts.
So that was like the 1600s or something.
Not quite.
Look, it's the millennium. If you want to talk to strangers, just
go on the internet. I'm sure there are plenty of pervs who'd love to talk to you.
The internet's a huge mess already.
Real life strangers, though.
They're the best people to talk to. No judgment, no reputation to worry about. They just listen.
Okay.
So?
Can I help you?
No, I can help you.
What?
Aren't you upset about something?
Yeah, it's personal.
And I'm a stranger. Won't you tell me about it?
Here's something else.
Thank you.
That was more of an observation than a compliment.
I like being different.
All right.
Well?
Well?
Is being in between jobs what's bothering you?
No, I told you, it's personal.
Why do you care what some stranger thinks?
You're right! Why should I care? I'm Faith, I'm 25 years old, and last night I got arrested for carrying $3,000 worth of cocaine for my shit ex-boyfriend, but whatever.
Been there, done that.
You're full of shit.
You're right. I kid, but so that's what's bothering you?
No. I'm mad because I'm still being punished for it.
You didn't know smuggling drugs was illegal?
I didn't know they were in the backpack.
Whose backpack?
His!
And you normally walk around with
this
backpack?
Look, he just told me to do it, okay?
I bet you'll have a phobia for other people's backpacks from now on, won't you?
Dominic, I think you should leave now.
So, it's funny, isn't it?
No, your jokes aren't funny.
No, I mean that he put marijuana...
Cocaine.
Cocaine. He put cocaine in his backpack and was too chicken to deliver it himself. I mean, was he a big guy?
Bigger than you.
And he made his girlfriend do a drug trade for him. That's hilarious.
Dominic, you have 5 seconds to leave.
How are they punishing you?
Communion service.
What kind?
I have to push lunch carts and other stupid shit at some hospital my friend works at.
Is this friend also a drug dealer?
I mean, she gives sick people pills, probably.
Nice. Just don't touch a backpack, okay? For how long?
2 months.
Yikes.
Yep. 2 months of bullshit I don't want to do.
I can relate.
Really?
Doing something that you don't want to? You might be shocked, but I don't plan on flipping burgers forever.
What, do you want to be like a professor?
Yes, ma'am. Every 6 months you get to meet hundreds of strangers and pass on your philosophies to them. There are all sorts of jobs where you can be helpful to people. It just depends what your calling is. You just have to listen so that you can hear it calling you.
Yeah. It were that easy.
Who were you gonna call?
No one.
Doesn't look that great to me.
You know, there becomes a point where asking strangers questions can become rude.
Just trying to help.
Sorry.
So who were you gonna call?
My dad, maybe.
Is everything okay at home?
I don't have a home.
That bad?
It's just me and my dad.
Siblings?
I'm an only child.
Mom?
No, Mom.
Sorry.
It's whatever.
And Dad wasn't a good guy?
Sometimes. He tried.
Have you seen him lately?
Not in 7 years.
Have you tried?
The last time I saw him, I wasn't planning on sending him any Christmas cards.
Why?
He hit me.
Do you want to talk about it?
He was an alcoholic.
Me too! Sorry.
I moved out as soon as I turned 18.
Where'd you go?
Far away.
Thank you for sharing.
Thanks for listening.
Does anyone else know about this?
Just my one friend, the one who works at the hospital. We went to middle school together. And she saw it all firsthand.
Anyone else?
Besides family? No.
And you want to call your dad?
He wrote me a letter.
What did it say?
I don't know, I didn't open it.
I think you should call him and get it over with, because repression gives you ulcers.
That's something my friend would say.
The nurse?
Yeah.
You know, I had a fun encounter with the nurse one time.
Broke your leg?
I called a phone number on the back of a bathroom stall.
What?
One time I actually called a phone number on the back of a bathroom stall just to see who would answer. I got the reception desk at a nursing home. It isn't exactly my idea of a call for a great time, but we got to talking for a minute or two, but she hung up.
Why would you call the number off of a bathroom stall?
Curiosity.
Off of a bathroom stall.
Bathroom stalls are covered in neat things. Crude drawings, people claiming that Obama's part of the Illuminati and stupid stuff like that. One time, I actually wrote on the back of the door, "The only life wasted is the one spent alone." I was answered with a haiku, "Some wise words." How cute. "Why am I alone, you ask?" One word, man. Herpes. Not the response I was hoping for, but some stranger replied. Some stranger with herpes. But still, some of the deepest thoughts can come right out of the bathroom.
And you write your philosophies on the back of bathroom stalls.
Everyone goes to the bathroom. It's just one more way to share those philosophies. It's like a forum for strangers, a very disgusting forum.
True, I guess.
Well, I don't write my phone number on the back of bathroom stalls because some strangers can be dangerous, but you don't look that strange to me. Do you want to talk again sometime?
Want to share more philosophies?
Maybe, maybe not, but it can't hurt to have someone to talk to.
Sure.
All right. I'll start hanging out then. My shift started 10 minutes ago.
Why the fuck were you talking to me then?
I've already told you. You were mad about your drugs, I was mad about my jewelry, and the rest is history.
Right.
Good luck with the nursing thing. I'll keep you in my thoughts, my prayers, or whatever's politically correct these days.
Sure. Dominic. Thanks. Home, like, home, 7 years later. say you're sorry. And you knock on the door. It's someone else. Your aunt doesn't live there anymore. You sigh. Stop. So, exams?
Yeah, they basically decide my medical future. So, I'm pretty much fucked!
What you got? Oh, this? They're my Polaroids.
No way, the ones we took!
Yeah, remember that camera we found in the garbage by that man's house when we were waiting for the bus? Sixth grade.
No way!
Oh my god, the tire's swing.
Oh my gosh, and it's that, what was his name? Danny from down the street. And we would swing and see people kick their shoe off.
Yeah, he was a little fuck boy.
No, I hit his dad's head with my shoe and he made us go home after that.
Yeah. Time flies.
Yeah.
Do you have any more?
Nah, my dad put all the ones from when we were a kid away.
Oh. So are any of these books yours? Anything else here?
Nah, I think we got everything.
Okay. You ready to go then?
Can I ask you something first?
Yeah.
What's it like to be around sick people all the time?
Oh. Well, there's different kinds of sick.
What kind? Any kind.
Honestly, you'll probably just unclog a toilet here and there and push patients to their appointments. There's auxiliary staff really doesn't do much.
They gave me an attendance sheet.
Probably give it to the receptionist.
No, my parole officer said that I have to meet with like a doctor or a nurse or something.
Oh, well, definitely not someone in my ward. But if they are on medical staff, you might get to see something interesting. For instance, last week this guy came in because he blew off half of his hand.
What?
Yeah. He was cooking over an open flame, and he had the PAM pointing in the wrong direction. And
wow.
Yeah, he lost 3 fingers.
He
lucky,
was dumb.
His face was fine.
He was dumb. Dumb as fuck.
You really can't say that on the floor.
I'll try to control it. I'll try to control the impulse.
Faith, I'm serious. There's a lot of people there, including kids.
Great.
It'll be okay. It'll be fine. A lot of things are routine. You know, flu shot, physical therapy, some checkups. It'll be fine.
All right, let's get out of this dump.
Don't you want to say goodbye?
Sure.
Bye.
Let's go.
Okay. Some plague acid.
It's present in most viruses, but not all. We've been over it 12 times.
And they're macromolecules, or are they micro?
Macro.
Ah, crap, and I knew that one. Okay, and satellite viruses, there are two kinds.
Yeah. Alpha and?
Beta. Shoot.
Okay. And what is a satellite virus?
One from outer space? Pew pew.
No. I feel like I know these better than you, and I only heard you recite this shit to me for like a few hours last night.
Satellite viruses.
Need another virus to replicate.
I'm doomed.
Or your brain is just leaking because you've crammed an unholy amount of bio into it.
Doomed!
This is the East Wing, isn't it?
Yeah, they're probably just running late.
Yeah, and I'll probably be running out soon.
Oh no, I'm not picking you up from jail again.
Who rained on his parades?
Anthony, he's always like that.
Joy.
Well, it's getting late. I should check in with Williams and Warren.
Smile, okay?
Hey, you might like it here. You could be picking up trash off the highway.
You got it, Dom.
I'm Nurse Parker here.
You got it.
Right. Well, I really gotta go. Have fun, don't break anything. See you at lunch.
Hey. Lighten up.
Excuse me?
Crack a smile, won't ya?
Piss off.
No. Just try to be nice. Whatever, dick.
Convict.
Were you eavesdropping?
You talk loudly.
And you couldn't mind your own goddamn business?
It's my job to listen to people around here. Some of us are actually here to work.
Yeah, I am too.
Then act like it.
I'm sorry, did I meet you in a past life and like beat you up or something?
Ma'am, I'm just here to work, so please, watch the language.
I just told you to lighten up is all.
I'll try.
Ma'am?
Yes?
Are you Miss...
Faith. Nice to meet you.
Nice to have you.
And are you my...
Consider me your one-man welcome wagon. Doctor, can't go wrong with writing, sir, doctor.
Yes.
I almost had that put on my business cards, but the wife wasn't having it. Anyways, you're here for community service?
Correct.
Wonderful.
Yep.
Well, there isn't much in the way of manual labor.
Then what is it that I'm doing?
Well, you'll be following Nurse Thompson around. She's the one that's appointed by the state to supervise you.
Supervise?
Your hours of community service.
Okay, and what am I doing?
Well, you'll be following her around and taking orders from her. You'll get along, but just a few basics. Wash your hands before and after touching any equipment. Wear gloves when you're instructed to, and if you need to smoke, go out by the loading dock to do it. Just keep everything clean, okay?
Right.
Right. I need two signatures real quick. First one's just a waiver holding you responsible for whatever you do here. It's just a formality. If you break something, we'll figure it out. The second one is from the municipality about the legal business.
So,
I have a pre-op conference to get to, and if you just stick around, I'll have the secretary send in Nurse Thompson right away. If you have any questions, anything, just ask for me at the front desk. I'll be glad to help however I can, whenever I get a free moment.
Hey, sir. I didn't do anything wrong.
Well, if you did anything wrong, you wouldn't be here. Sometimes I like to think we can be victims of circumstance. Welcome aboard, Fallon.
It's Faith.
Right.
There's only so much that medicine can do, and while it can do a lot of what we do here is personal. We do a lot of talking.
I guess I've been in customer service long enough to fake compassion.
Nurses do spend time in prep with the doctors and making sure patients take their medication on time, but we get to know everyone that walks through that front door on a personal level. Some are awful to work with, but with some positivity, the results might shock you. The power of encouragement and recuperation, compassion, care, is what helps some people with recovery.
I mean, old people, though, like, especially with pneumonia, that's gotta be rough.
That's the other thing. Care and compassion help a lot in recovery, but there are some patients who are beyond recovery.
Terminal?
It's a part of life, but even when recovery isn't possible, we still show as much care as possible.
Do you deal with a lot of that?
Not too often, but it's inevitable. It's a part of life.
Dying.
Like some writer once said, it's a vicious cycle.
Laura, something you should know about me, I don't really stay in one place for very long, and 2 months is a long time for me.
What are you running from?
Nothing.
Well, maybe you need a breather.
Not really. Sorry. I've made some mistakes. Moving around makes it easier to forget.
Live long enough to be my age and you start to forget everything. You know, you're such a striking young lady. I bet you have a lot of gentlemen following you around.
I'm concerned about the end of a long-term relationship. It's complicated.
Sorry to hear that.
Are we allowed to wear jewelry?
You can get away with some things. Are you ready for the boring part?
Paperwork.
I basically have to read this out loud to you for good measure.
Let's get it over with.
Just some corporate hoopla. You get a 30-minute break each day because at that point you've reached your peak efficiency. During that time, you can go out or stay in.
Let me in.
exciting can happen with you guys.
I walked a little boy to the bathroom, and he puked on my shoes.
Well, I feel lucky, huh?
Oh my God, do people ever stop talking?
We're just worried about classes.
And if it's worth it?
I'm sorry, what?
What if you get your degree, and then a year down the road, you decide you don't like being a doctor? Will it be worth it then?
I sure hope so.
Will the loans be worth it?
That's enough.
There's nothing wrong with being practical.
No, but there is with being an asshole.
If being practical's wrong, I don't want to be right.
Just shut it.
It's fine, Faith. It's fine.
Yeah, no need to get defensive.
Excuse me?
Dear.
I don't understand why women get so defensive over little things like that.
Maybe because some things aren't so little to everyone.
It's really okay.
No, Beatrice, stand up for yourself.
So touchy today.
Cool it, buddy!
We all work here, and let's just try to get along.
Yeah, it's being civil, not practical.
Who pissed in your Cheerios, miss?
Hey! Shut up. Yeah. First of all, don't call me miss. And second, you did. I tried being nice to you this morning, and you yelled at me, dick. I can't stand people like you.
And exactly what kind of person am I?
Somebody who takes their problems out on everyone else.
Oh, my problems. What would those be?
I don't know your life.
Exactly. You don't know me at all. So mind your own business. I was talking to Mrs. Parker.
Yeah, well, her business is my business, pal.
Then why don't you tell us a little bit about yourself?
That's none of your business.
And that's why I don't get people like you.
People like me? Please tell me, Captain Hypocrite. What kind of person am I?
You think you know everything when you don't. And if you have a problem with me, just be straight about it.
We're done here.
Good. Okay, let's change the subject. Puppy!
Puppy! Puppy!
That's all I wanted to do. I just wanted to sit here and eat my lunch in peace and quiet without these monologues about roaming the halls and exams and crap.
You know, Faith is really usually a pretty laid-back girl, and Anthony, I'm sure you're a okay kind of guy. Yeah, so let's just all get along. Let's make peace. Let's be friends.
No, I seem to remember something about being arrested this morning.
And that was none of your business. Now fuck off or we will have a problem.
I swear.
As long
people
as
swear.
Cynicism to yourself.
No promises.
May I interject, please? Okay, see, I think that the problem here is that Anthony here, is just having trouble relating to women.
Taking a break.
Just enjoying the sun, then. I don't blame
a great way to spend your day off.
Yep. So, do you have a garden?
I have some pots inside around the house, not your traditional garden. I do have some edible plants, like mint and basil, and some hanging tomato plants. Kids walk by and I tell them to take some leaves and chew that, some gum. Better for your teeth. Beautiful.
What?
When the leaves start changing colors, it's bitter with boredom. See that one over there?
Which one?
Between the azalea and the evergreen, next to the brick house. Do you see it?
Yeah, it's starting to turn, I guess.
It's nice to just sit outside and live.
Live.
It's so easy to rush by and forget to smile at the rising sun in the morning or to be thankful for the gentle breezes.
I don't think I know anyone that's literally stopped to smell the roses.
I like living slower.
Slower?
If you move too fast, you can miss the important things.
I try that sometimes. Slowing down. I think it's easier when you're a kid.
You can learn a lot from kids.
Do you really live every day like that?
Heavens no. I don't think a man alive could. It's good to try, though. Do you want to try?
You want me to move in slow motion?
No, just sit. Sit and look. Take a breath. Deep breath. Absorb everything. Take a picture with your mind. Like this is a moment that we want to remember. I said look, honey, not glare. You look like a gargoyle.
You know, I had this teacher once. His name was Mr. Davies. He was like 28 or 29 or something, pretty young guy. Anyway, he taught chemistry and I hated that class. He wore the ugliest ties every day too, like this wooden one or an alligator one. But I looked forward to it every day. See if he could top yesterday's disaster. He would take us outside on days like today and provide that kind of lesson. He told us that if we got every alkaline earth metal correct on our periodic table quiz, he would do a cartwheel in class. And none of us believed it, because like, come on dude, you can't do that. But sure enough, we all got it right. And he did a cartwheel. Knocked the projector over too.
What a catch.
Yeah. And then one day he just quit. He came into class with his bag, and he handed us each a ceramic mug that said, stay in school, don't be a moron. He said, I'm not spending enough time with my wife and boys, so I need to give up chemistry for a little bit. He said they just don't stop growing up. I hope you guys understand. Now, every time I see something periodic, I immediately think of those god-awful ties.
When was the last time you saw him?
Oh, not for years. I don't even know why that thought just came to me now.
Senses stimulate memory. Maybe enjoying the view made you think of him.
I wonder how his boys are now. Why are you a nurse?
When I was a girl, my grandmother came to live with us. She was only 60, but she fell and broke her hip, and she spent a lot of time in the hospital and then at our house. There was this nurse that came to check in on her, and that sparked my interest. Family's always been something that is very important to me.
Do you have a family?
One time I had a family.
Good?
Sort of.
How do you mean?
I had a baby, premature. I only got to hold her for 6 minutes.
You would have been a great mother.
It goes by so fast. There's only so much time to eat breakfast with your brothers and sisters, or to celebrate birthdays, or to say, I love you. We just keep going around doing these silly things and just acting like the world just isn't going to stop. Only so much time left to walk the dog, or jump the train, or eat a Linzer toy. If I die before I have another Linzer tart, it'll be too soon. I actually got you something. I picked it up on my way here.
You didn't have to.
I know, but I know you said you like to paint. Well, graffiti paint anyway, but maybe now you can try a real canvas.
I don't know what to say.
Don't say anything. Paint.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Hey!
Well, I should get going. It was good to see you. Say hi to your friend.
Do you want to meet him?
Oh, dear. I'll see you soon.
Hey, stranger. I had no idea you lived here.
Yeah, apparently everyone's reaching that conclusion today.
What?
My nurse, counselor, family lady, she just passed. You just missed her.
I meant to call Tuna. How's it going?
It's fine. It's going fine.
I asked how it's going.
Yes, you did. And I said it was fine.
Fine can mean anything. Fine can mean it was just okay. Fine can mean it was really great, but I don't want to sound too excited about it. Fine can also mean it was horrible and I don't want to talk about it.
Fine means that I don't know.
Fine.
What?
All right, care to elaborate?
It's hardly been 2 weeks.
I don't need a thoughtful explanation, just a first impression.
I don't know.
What don't you know?
Look, I've never held on to a job for longer than a year, ever.
Why?
They never work out.
Are you a shitty worker?
No.
Are you really unlucky?
No shit.
The only other thing that I can think of is the fear of failure. You know? Failure always comes before success.
Or it comes before more failure.
Give me an example.
Okay. I worked at a home improvement store back in my hometown.
And?
I had a couple come in and ask me what paint to use for their living room. I showed them a couple nice reds, and they went home, painted their living room, come back the next day complaining that the luster of the paint was terrible, and that the sun caused a bad reflection off of it.
Big woo! They could just paint over it.
Fine. I was a receptionist once too. And all I had to do was write down the numbers of people who wanted to use the banquet hall at a community center. I wrote down the name of a woman who was celebrating her silver anniversary on a piece of paper and not in the computer. And the secretary after me scheduled a class reunion for the same time, same day. When both parties showed up, they were both pissed and demanded a refund.
Customers complain all the time. Just ignore it, you're never gonna see them again.
I was a waitress a few months ago, before I moved here.
Did you take a wrong order?
Yeah.
Oh, no. Oh God, how could you take a wrong order, you monster? I hand people the wrong stuff all the time. It's just a bit awkward when they tell you that you made a mistake and then you give them something else. Worst case scenario, you don't get a tip.
It's not like that.
What? Did you spill water on them too?
No. I had a guy ask for a burger with no tomato. I forgot to write no tomato on the ticket. I give him his burger, he takes a bite, I go back to the kitchen to go get him a soda. I come back, he's on the floor. His lungs swelled shut. Allergic to tomatoes. The ambulance came just in time.
Shit.
My boss started yelling at me.
And you got fired.
No, I quit.
Why?
Why? Because I failed.
Yes, you failed. However, you took the first 50 orders correctly that day.
For weeks after that day, I just couldn't get the image of that guy on the floor out of my brain. I mean, I almost killed a man. It's not just jobs. Everywhere I go, I fuck up. And it's not fair that I fuck up everywhere I go. And it's just my jobs. My boyfriend used me for a fucking drug trade, and the one before that dumped me because I didn't want to move in with him, and the list just goes on and on.
So it's not fine.
It's fine.
What's your therapy?
I'm not in therapy.
Your therapy, your secret release, the thing that makes you your best self.
You mean a hobby?
Not necessarily, but sure.
I don't think I get what you mean.
Well, here's what I mean. Hello there.
Hi. Have we met?
Did you get a triple cheeseburger today?
I don't know what you're talking about.
I told you to have a nice day and you wouldn't even look at me. I remember you.
That's impossible. I don't eat fast food, so.
Greasy Dave's isn't fast food that you certainly don't.
I thought you were trying that all organic diet thing.
Hey! Do you want to introduce me to your new friend?
I'm Dominic, miss. Sorry that I'm not wearing my name tag afterward.
Lovely.
Dominic, this is my roommate Beatrice.
How do you do?
Quite nicely. Thank you. Now, Faye, as you would observe, Beatrice's therapy is a triple cheeseburger.
What in the world are you talking about?
Is something stressing you out, Beatrice?
Come again?
Stress? You wouldn't even look at me today when you got your burger. The entire time you were waiting for it, you were pacing. You were making me stressed out. Secondhand stressed out.
She started graduate classes a few weeks ago.
Congratulations.
Thanks.
So you're worried about these classes?
Of course not.
She's very stressed out.
Am not.
It doesn't matter if you are. It's perfectly normal.
Okay. So, what if I am stressed?
Nothing. I was just telling Faith about therapy, someone was using your triple cheeseburger as an example.
Hey, just because I ate a triple cheeseburger doesn't mean that I need therapy.
The burger is your therapy. It makes you less stressed.
I don't need a therapy.
I would have to disagree. I'm 24 years old, single, working in a fast food center with no clear motivation to press forward in life. You might think I'm depressed, but I smile. You know why? Poetry.
Poetry?
It's my therapy. Henry David Thoreau decided to live in the woods, away from man and away from his possessions. He had very little and he wrote poetry. It helped him live amongst the materialist people around him. Grad school is full of pretentious assholes who think that their thesis is a God's gift to humankind, whereas they just paraphrased articles of a database. And I live in my wilderness amongst the fryers and the ovens to look deliberately. And I write poetry. It's my therapy. It helps me live amongst the pessimistic thoughts of those around me. You ate a triple cheeseburger to relieve some stress. I've seen you there recently. It's okay to have a therapy, but try our apple walnut salad. It's much better for you.
You've been watching me?
It's hard not to when I work there, but it's just a bonus that a beautiful woman keeps dropping by. So, Faith, do you have a therapy? Do you play basketball, sing, or knit?
No.
Then we're gonna find you a therapy.
Good luck with that.
Whether or not that was sarcastic, thank you for the support. I think we should take a walk, figure things out.
Oh, all right, I'll bite. Let's go. This is all the therapy I need.
Vocabulary, and I think we could be friends.
You
That is a canvas.
You paint?
Well, I'm just trying out a new medium.
But I,
it's not done yet.
Spoken like a true artist.
This is my first time using, like, real oil tubes and, like, a canvas. It's total crap.
Well, some other time then. Soon.
The obligatory transition. So,
Anthony.
What about him?
Well, normally when people go to the movies, they watch the movie, not the person next to them.
Was he?
Yeah. Come on, he walked you all the way back to your car.
Yeah, that's because I drove us all there.
You are so blind! It's the classic elementary school crush. Sally likes Jimmy, so Sally seals his blocks and rubs his face in the dirt to show her affection.
No shit, are you?
We're waiting until I finish school, but...
Do you have a ring?
Well, I don't know if you've noticed this about me, but I'm mildly obsessive compulsive.
Yeah, I guess.
Well, I just don't like wearing it unless I'm with him, and I can't wear it at work, so...
What's he like?
He's a mechanic.
Just to talk for a minute, is that okay? can sit too.
I'm fine.
It's a good night. It's nice and cool after the rain.
Why are you here?
Just to talk.
About what?
Can you let me try to have a conversation without arguing an insult?
You had no problem arguing with me before.
You're easy to argue with.
Is that what you came here to do?
Can you just let me try to be nice?
Fine.
So, you live here?
Until I get back on my feet, yeah.
Plans?
I'll figure something out.
Are you going to skip town once you're back on your feet?
That's the plan.
Why?
Not off to a great start.
Can I ask you something?
You just did.
Are you in?
What?
What happened?
That's very vague.
You got arrested?
Yes.
For?
Drugs.
Care to elaborate?
My boyfriend slipped cocaine into my backpack. I got pulled over and the cops hauled me downtown when they found it. The court decided that I was already deviant because of a few vandalism misdemeanors, so they decided I should provide community service for my crime. Total bullshit.
Yeah, that's really crappy.
Anything else you want to ask?
What happened to your boyfriend?
Ex, he's in jail.
Are you still angry?
No, there's no point. I'm fine.
I'm sorry.
It's not your fault.
No, I'm sorry.
For what?
For being a dick, kicking you while you were down.
Good one.
No, I mean it. I half believe it myself. No, it was very dickish.
You can say that again.
Obviously, I said something to set you off when we met.
Yeah, flinging my personal crap out in the open just... Ah! Love it when people do that!
It just happened, okay? Can we start over?
What?
My name is Anthony. Sometimes I'm an asshole. I mean one.
Okay.
Are you okay?
Yeah, I guess, whatever.
Do you mean that, or are you just saying?
It's a start.
Making progress.
Tell me about yourself.
What would you like to know?
Anything, like, why are you a nurse?
When I was 5, I had trouble standing for long periods of time. It got so bad I couldn't get out of bed in the morning. He had this awful pediatrician, didn't know what was wrong for years. It got bad enough that I couldn't even go to school. I missed out on kindergarten. When they shut down their clinic, we got a new doctor. Turns out I had polio. I had this really great nurse come visit me once a week at home. Her name was Anne, and she promised me that I'd walk again. I told her that if I did, I'd run a marathon. And here I am today, walking.
Can you run marathons?
What? Hell no. My legs hurt like a bitch for years.
Polio.
Thank God for Jonas Salk.
It's getting late.
Right. Cool. I guess I'll see you around the floor.
Yeah.
I hope there aren't any hard feelings.
See you later.
Been through one of the world wars, built his own auto repair shop from scratch, and he can't remember what he had for breakfast this morning.
Wow.
His plane was shot down and he walked away with bruises. There's still a bit of shrapnel from the grenade when he was in the trench in his left thigh. Bullet would have went through his skull too had he not been wearing a helmet. There was an angel on his shoulder, that's for sure. At least that's what his sons tell us. He doesn't remember a lick of it, but he likes watching planes.
Are you supposed to die in a week?
It's impossible to know. But he's hardly mobile. Changes in appetite, send up red flags. And geriatrics, we work on preventing illness, but there's a point where the body's reached its end.
Where's his family?
Out of the country, we can't reach them.
So that's it? He's just gonna die alone?
He might hold out. He's a strong man. But due back at the end of the month. I've seen cancer patients outlive their prognosis threefold, but in the meantime, if they don't make it back, we owe it to him to make his transition as peaceful as possible.
He has a hospice evaluation at 5, right?
Yes. Jacob, we're going to take you to see Nurse Levitt now. Does that sound good?
Mr. Kantz, did you enjoy your view? Did you see the plane? Do you need to use the restroom?
You're so tall.
Thank you. Do you need to use the restroom? Are you ready to go?
Keeping the time helps his memory. He wants to get it himself, though. Just place a hand here and here. Steady now.
Thank you, Mary.
Mary's his daughter. I think that's good for today, though.
Here we go, Jacob. Did you enjoy the tuna for lunch today?
Thanks, Hope. Is everything all right?
Laura, do you? You can never imagine feeling this, so I guess you can't really. Could you imagine ever feeling so rotten on the inside that you just stopped caring?
I don't know if I understand.
I've spent the last 6 or 7, maybe 8 years. I don't know, it's hard to remember. I've pushed a lot of people away. And I feel a lot of them deserved it, but then I just kept pushing and pushing until no one was left. I started slacking in things, like work. Like I couldn't even be bothered to go sometimes. And I started the whole tagging thing, and I gave up on everything that was too hard for me. I'm so sick of it. I'm so sick of failing at everything I try before I do it. And I stopped making friends. And I said goodbye to all the ones that I had. I was just scared that they were judging me. I was embarrassed. And I haven't told my dad I loved him since I was in high school. And maybe, I think, deep down I do. Maybe I do hate him, though, and I might, but either way, he's the only parent I ever had. He might have tricked himself into a coma without me around. And I'm not there for him. Just like Jacob's kids. I'm not there. I never gave him the chance to apologize. I never apologized to him. And I think that would be the worst thing to live with. Regret. If I just never talked to him again. I never even said sorry to my aunt. God, I need therapy.
Sweetie. Sometimes when things go wrong in the world, like someone gets a really terrible start or they're going through a rough patch, the universe finds a way to make it okay. I know that you didn't have a lot of love growing up as a girl, but there is so much love waiting for you. Feel it in your friend. The one that got you a job here, feel it in friends. You feel it in me, sweetie. I've seen compassion you from the moment I met you. Don't be afraid to feel. Broken pieces can be put back together again. Love's a strong glue, you know. God loves you.
Yeah.
Don't you believe in God?
I don't believe in things that I can't see.
Do you believe in angels?
I don't know, maybe.
Well, believe in something. Something greater, whether that's the universe or love, just know that something is always there for you. Something will always care.
You're wise beyond your years, Laura.
I'm pretty old, Faith.
Faith! 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 Faith!
I didn't know you were a geriatrist, okay?
Yeah, Beatrice, this is Laura.
Totally fucked!
I'm fine. Well, I'm not fine because I got a 65% on my exam.
Okay, look, you're in work right now, not school, so focus on work.
Hey, I'm not the one who's been crying. Maybe you need to focus on work.
Look, we'll go get ice cream later or something. Just chill out.
I should get to Miss Gilmore next door. Excuse me.
Thank you.
What?
Not you!
I'm sorry, did you not hear me about my 65? This is a big hole!
Rude much?
Oh, I'm sorry. Do you not understand? Maybe you don't understand the magnitude to which I have to dig myself out of this
you
shit!
You could have at least said hello.
Hello? Oh, there's no time for hello. I need to cram.
If you open one book today, I'm gonna smack you.
I can't stop reading. Because if I stop reading, then I'm going to forget 90% of what I've already read. And if I do that, then I can't take the practice quizzes. And if I don't take the practice quizzes, then I'm gonna fail the exam. And right now, I don't even know the difference between the 5 different dopamine receptors or the results of the double-blind experiment we did last week or the different toxins that
Beatrice, calm down!
Or the difference between regurgitation and vomit!
Oh my god, either way, that's gross. Look, what you need is to take a step back and take a nap or something. When was the last time you slept?
Sleep? What is sleep?
Sleep is the best medicine for you right now.
But if I sleep right now, then I can't study.
If you don't sleep, then you can't focus. Look, Beatrice, you are not a robot. People have needs, and believe it or not, school isn't everything.
But I feel like all I do anymore is go to school, go to class, go to work, do homework, study, take exams, lock myself in my room to do more homework. Med school is like outrunning a bear. And I can't outrun a bear. I can't even outrun the other people. So I carry around this bag of books to throw at the other people. That way I can get ahead. Yeah, but
you know what? You're right. I am only human. I had other interests. I actually used to be a dancer.
Really?
Yeah, I studied ballet for 2 years after you left. It's the only non-academic thing on my resume.
Why did you stop?
Why do you think books aren't going to read themselves? Fake internships, scholarships, residencies.
Beatrice, are you happy?
Of course I am!
Yeah, okay, psycho. Look, we're gonna go get some ice cream later. Doctor's orders.
Don't be cute with me, Missy. Ice cream doesn't get better grades. Ice cream just makes you fat.
Chill. I'm just trying to help the best way I know how.
You're right. I'm sorry. We get off in 5 anyways, so we can get ice cream or whatever.
All right, I'm just gonna go say goodbye.
Bye.
To Laura.
Whatever. Oh, crap.
Oh, crap! I didn't put more quarters in the meter! I'm not gonna get
my train to me!
Grumpy Gills.
What got you down?
Nothing.
Anthony, you can't
because everything is fine.
Oh, everything. You know, when someone says they're fine, they are most definitely not, unless they're smiling.
What makes you the expert?
I'm a girl!
Wow, you're definitely overthinking this.
Strike two. It is called analyzing. I hear things, I reflect, and I analyze. You're a nurse, you do it.
Fine, just stop. Reflect. Analyze.
Yes.
Now summarize your day in one sentence.
You asked for it, buddy.
Everywhere. I can't. That's great.
That's because we work on rotation in the wards. At least I've specialized in a few fields.
Whatever.
At least I don't get upset easily.
You exploded on me my first week here!
I'm pretty sure that was you who did
No,
that.
I snapped. There's a difference.
Sounded the same to me.
No. Snapping is what you do when you're provoked. You provoked me. You don't know me.
It's not that I haven't tried, but you keep shutting me out.
Look, we're not talking about me. We're talking about Beatrice, and what she needs right now is encouragement, not drugs in school. So cut the crap.
I feel like we've already segued to my bad mood.
And you just admitted it yourself.
I was with the gynecologist today. A woman came in a week ago for a pap smear. Random checkup. Decided to have blood work done, too. Today it was my job to tell her she was HIV positive.
Shit.
She looked just like my sister.
I'm sorry.
Spooked me.
I'm sorry.
Stuff like that, it just makes me wonder why I'm even here. But then I remember that negligent doctor I had as a kid. Someone has to be here to take care of these people.
I'm sorry.
It's fine. It's that, and I can't stand when I find Elizabeth roaming the hallways, probably trying to find her brain.
Why are you telling me this?
I don't know. It feels safe with you. I mean, I know you don't like me, but I don't think you'd go around talking bad about me to other people.
Oh, I do. Well, I don't. I called you a fuckboy, but that was about it.
You know, I meant to say it earlier, between insults, but you're very striking. You have beautiful eyes.
What?
Just let me try to be nice, please.
Thanks.
Don't mention it.
I won't. I'm late.
I've never seen you fluster.
Yeah, don't get used to it. I'll see you around.
Sorry, I didn't have time to take a shower. I just came straight looking for you.
No, I mean you read.
It's not.
What the fuck?
harmless. It's completely-
It's illegal! I don't give a shit how bad it is for you! And you said you came straight to see me. I'm fucking
believable. Once you're in, though, you're in! Guess who'll pay my bill?
I don't care!
I don't know how to get out of this.
Just leave! Move! Go far away!
I'm sorry! It's just... I need help.
Yeah, me. That's a start.
Would you help me?
Professional help is what you need.
But I need you there with me. What can I do, Faith? What can I possibly do to even make up for this?
Let me go.
What?
You need to let me go. Peter.
Faith, I did all of this for you.
We both know that's not
I'm
true.
I'm still helping you, though.
Peter, but I don't
care. Stop! I'm sorry. I still have a lot to work on.
Peter, just shut up and listen for a second. I'm glad you can admit you have a problem. I do too. And I've been working on it ever since this whole shit happened, but what we're doing, what we were doing, we weren't right for each other, Peter.
Yeah, I screwed up, but I didn't tell you because I love you too.
Yeah, love's a big word.
Hey, can't we talk?
Peter, I need to do what's right for myself. I'm finally turning over a new leaf. I can't do this, Peter. I'm an adult and I can take care of myself! And it's about time I stopped relying on deadbeats!
A deadbeat?
Prove me wrong! Please, prove me wrong! I hope more than anything that you prove me wrong someday.
I'm a deadbeat.
Peter, that's not what I'm-
You fucking bitch, who need to say something?
What?
After everything I've done-
Yeah, all the shit you put me through, thanks a lot!
Watch your fucking mouth.
I'll say whatever the fuck I want to, and that's my own fucking business.
Can't we just go home and talk for a second? I have a lot to tell you.
We could have talked before all this shit happened. What do you mean home?
Home, our apartment.
Your apartment.
What do you mean?
Do I look happy to see you?
Come home, just relax. You can ask me whatever you want,
and
you'll get an answer.
I can't hear this right now.
Come home.
No.
That wasn't a request.
I have a new home.
No, you don't. Now get in my car, and we'll talk.
Peter, you're dead to me. You're out of my life.
Babe. Get in the car!
I don't need to talk to you! I don't need an explanation, and I don't need you! Now leave, or I'll call the cops, and that's the last fucking thing you need.
Calm down, babe! I'm not gonna hurt you!
Let me go! You love me! Let me go!
Just give me 5 minutes!
Oh, man!
How long? How long have you been selling coke?
2 months!
Quit lying to me!
Okay! Okay! A year! A fucking year! Then fucking what?
Goodbye, Peter.
I'm not going anywhere. And you can't just run away from your problems. They catch up to you, and bad shit happens. And if you don't come back with me right now, then you're gonna be all alone again. I'm gonna be as nice as I possibly can. Come home, and we'll forget that this ever happened, and it'll be just like it used to be, all right? Let's go.
No.
I'm not asking you anymore. I'm telling you.
Oh my God, do you think I'm that stupid? You need me to keep doing your job for you. Do it yourself. Absolutely. If you touch me again, I'll break your hand.
I feel like you're not even listening. I didn't know you had
allergies. Xanax. Oh shit. Come on your feet. It's okay, Beatrice.
Show me what to do.
Hello? Hi, I was wondering if Nurse Thompson is still in. Yes, hi, Elizabeth. It's Faith. Can you go check for me, please? Hello? Yes, Nurse Thompson. Laura Thompson. Just forget it. I'm coming in. I gotta go back. Can you give me your keys, Don?
Wait, go with you.
Shouldn't someone stay here with her?
I'll stay with her. I'm a nurse. She'll be fine.
Thanks. Good luck. Laura?
Hello, Faith.
I called tonight.
I'll explain later.
Okay, look, let's say someone did made a really horrible mistake and I don't know, did something or something.
Darling, are you?
No, it's not me. It's just... my friend made a really stupid mistake and I don't know if I can trust this friend too well.
I'm afraid I can't help without more information.
I have a friend who's abusing drugs. We just found out and they swore off of them.
Do you know for how long?
A month, at least.
When someone does a recreational drug, it's voluntary. At first it becomes a habit, then a need. They could try and seek it out, even if there are grave consequences. Do you know what kinds of drugs?
It might have been more than one kind, I'm not sure.
Detoxification to start. It won't help to get rid of the cravings, but it'll help to clean out the system. Are you sure you don't know what kind?
No, but I'm sure this friend could tell us more.
Us?
More a couple other people, not.
Good. Your friend is going to need as much support as possible. A drug relapse could be catastrophic. Relapses happen, but having extra eyes on your friend should help to keep them straight. But you need patience. This isn't something that they can just quit. You need cognitive therapy, changing behavior. Why did they start? I mean, why did they feel the need to turn to these drugs?
I think because they needed my help and it wasn't enough. There is more to it.
Well, like I said, there's detoxification and cognitive therapy. Your friend's going to need counseling. You'll need it too.
But I didn't
I know. I believe you. But you need to learn more about this so that you can help your friend. I take classes all the time so that I can help patients. You need to learn about abuse victims, their bodies, signs of relapse. There's a lot, but admitting that they need help is the first step in the right direction.
Thank you, Laura. I knew I could count on you.
Just focus on helping your friend, Faith.
So what, be a nurse?
You've come a long way since you first started here. I just resigned.
What?
I finished my job here. It's about time I left.
But you're my counselor, right?
I am, and it's been a blessing, Faith. It really has. The boss, they said it's time that I left.
What?
I promise that you will understand very soon, but I need to leave.
Laura, you're the first person that's made me feel normal in a really long time.
It makes it that much harder to leave. Remember me when things get tough for you. Remember your first day here? You said I would have been a good mother?
Yeah.
Thank you.
I can't understand this, but I can't keep you here.
I love you.
When will I see you again?
It may not be for a very long time. Goodbye.
Goodbye.
Faith, don't be a boron. Go back to school.
Yeah, I will. I promise.
Faith!
Over here.
Did you find what you were looking for?
Yeah, I did.
Cool. Are you ready to head out?
Yeah, I just forgot something. I'll meet you at the front desk.
Here we go.
What are you talking about? I'm supposed to be here.
Here? At the hospital?
Yes, with Nurse Thompson.
Nurse Thompson?
Yes.
Nurse Thompson's been out with the flu. We couldn't have her here or else the older patients might have gotten sick. We had to take a short vacation until after she got better. Didn't the secretary tell you?
Elizabeth?
Yes.
No, she didn't.
Between you and me, I'm not sure how she got the job in the first place.
So, Nurse Thompson's out with the flu?
That's correct.
Laura Thompson?
No, Virginia Thompson.
Virginia Thompson?
Well, we call her Ginny.
I can't, so no Laura?
No, I don't believe we have a Laura on the staff. Funny, it's such a common name.
I can't believe this.
So, you haven't been here prior?
What?
Today?
No, I guess I just got the dates mixed up. Excited to start.
But I could have sworn I was
just once or twice. I was here with Beatrice, Nurse Parker. She was showing me around.
Well, I'm glad I'm not going crazy.
So, there's no one named Laura that works here?
Not to my knowledge, no. Maybe a few years ago, but no one comes to mind. Why do you ask?
Just curious, I guess. I thought I knew someone who worked here. Thanks for your time.
Please, call me Gabriel.
Okay, Gabriel.
Babe. Have a good night, kiddo.
Thanks.
Babe.
Yeah? I'm over here. Let's go home. Beatrice can wake up any minute, and I should be there for her.
You sure?
Yeah.
Oh, and I made a friend.
Ever stay at the front desk.
Clocked out, no need.
All right, well, we're heading out.
Oh, mind if I go with you? I took the bus this morning, but construction cut off the regular schedule, and I'm not about to get stuck on a street corner again with a bunch of crude men in hard hats talking about how sore their backs are. Have you heard of a leave, sir? It's great!
Do you know anyone that's here named Laura?
Laura?
Yeah.
No, but I heard you talk about her. She works in the other wing, right?
Yeah, the other wing.
Are we heading out then?
Sure. Do you live close to Mass now?
Well, sort of. I usually take a shortcut that goes right to the bus stop and takes me right there, except for that one time. I'll tell you about that one time. Okay, so my foot is totally stuck in there. The dog's having a seizure, and I still got half a pie left in there.
I know it's not for me anymore, and when you know, you just know.
Well, if it makes you happy, then it's the right thing.
You've spoken like a true philosopher, Liz.
I could use a friend, though.
I can do that.
Well, friend, can you help me get inside? I want to lay down, and my legs are still a little wobbly.
Of course. That must have been some awful food poisoning. Clams, you said?
Yeah, damn clams.
You know, if you order them at a restaurant and you get them and the shell isn't open, then
Elizabeth?
You shouldn't eat them. Yes?
Shut up.
No, whatever you say.
Yeah, I feel like I've been hit by a truck.
Figuratively.
Of course, figuratively. If it was literally, I'd be as flat as a pancake.
Oh, you dropped something, by the way.
I did?
More like I dumped it out of your bag.
Oh, no, I don't need the pills anymore.
Bills?
Bills! I don't need the bills, I can pay them all.
It is a bill, actually.
Gracie Dave's?
Oh my god, I ate so much that day.
Did you write down the recipe to a happy life? And a phone number?
If you ever need to talk and stuff. Just don't write it on a bathroom stall, please.
I think I'll keep this one for myself.
Let's go.
never heard such plain language from you.
Even Homer had his dull moments.
I thought I was special that day you gave me your number.
You needed me then, she needs me now.
So, the hospital.
Yeah.
Laura. Dominic, she was being really cryptic when I found her. She told me she quit her job, and then I found one of the doctors, and Dom, they told me no one named Laura works there.
That's a puzzle, isn't it?
You saw her too.
Huh?
That day you dropped in here, she was leaving as you were coming in.
Well, I've only been here once before today, and you were alone.
No, she heard you. She was here.
You were alone, Faith, when I found you.
You just saw her 10 minutes ago at the hospital. She was in the waiting room with me.
And she left before I found you?
Dominic, she was sitting right there staring at you.
Quit spooking me. There was no one there.
No,
you.
Beatrice saw her too that day with the old man. And she was being really rude that day, acting like Laura wasn't even there.
So no one saw her.
So no Laura.
That doesn't make sense.
But it couldn't have been some like random woman off the street. Like, she knew what she was talking about. She was definitely an RN.
Are you schizophrenic?
Whatever this is, it was real.
What is that?
Something I should have read weeks ago.
Was it from?
My dad.
Read it out loud then.
Dear Faith, it's been a long time, and honestly, I'd be shocked if you ever read this, but if you do, I might be able to sleep at night. The minute you were born, I fell in love with you. Your mother did too, even though she died of complications after childbirth. And I was terrified. Terrified of being a father. Terrified of raising you alone. Just a baby, you found wonder in everything and had a smile and promised everything would be fine. For a while, that's all I needed. Then you grew into the spitting image of your mother and it brought that fear back. Fear that I might lose you too. I resented you. And that was an unfair burden for you to bear. I didn't show you the love a child needs. The day I hit you is the day I quit drinking cold turkey. The nightmares were by greenish. I finally saw clearly. I saw how stupid I'd been. I'm a failure as a father and a man for the way I raised you. It was too late. You moved on. That was the right choice for you. I hid every trace of your mother from you, every picture, every memory, every story. I erased her completely. All the time I spent trying to forget her, I should have spent celebrating her memory with you. We met in detention. She corrected a teacher, brilliant for her age. I'd get caught smoking in the locker rooms during lunch. We spent the hour passing notes. We kissed for the first time during Thanksgiving break senior year of high school, lying in a hammock that we tied between two oaks. We had our first fight when she chose to go away to a state school while I did community college. That's the first time I told her I loved her. We drove a car across the country on spring break. And we ran out of money and slept in the trunk. Her father would have strangled me for that. We stuck through it all. And we moved in together during her master's. We ate at every pizza parlor you could imagine. Believe it or not, she proposed to me. It was my birthday and she stuffed this shoebox with every note we ever passed. I was surprised that she kept them, and at the bottom I found the wedding band. You should have seen how mortified my father was that I didn't ask first. We got married in November and it poured rain during the wedding march, but your mother was so happy. We said our I do's even through the lightning.
She worked in a children's hospital and I delivered mail. The day she conceived, she wept. She loved you before you even started kicking. And I loved you too. These memories reminded me of what I didn't have, what I could never have again. I was wrong because you are so much like her. Your voice, your sweet disposition, even the way you laugh. But you wouldn't know it because I never talked about her. And I pushed you away too. It was like she died all over again. And this time it was me that killed her. I missed out on so many memories of yours. I never taught you how to ride a bike, took you camping, watched a soccer game. And I never got to see you become a young woman. I'll never get those moments back. I can only imagine seeing you with a diploma, marrying a young man, having a beautiful child, and making your own life story. Faith, if you're anything like your mother, you'll find the beauty in every moment life gives you. I haven't been a part of that life, but I hope that someday you may find it in your heart to give me another chance. Attached is my number. I don't know if you lost it or chose to forget it. And I don't expect a call. I could never expect you to let me back in. If you give me this chance, I'll never let you down the way I did before. There's also a picture. It's time you learned who your parents were. I wouldn't blame you for moving on or even shredding this letter to begin with. And I can only pray that I might see you again. I love you. I love you more than life. And I hope you know this before I'm gone. Love, Dad. Oh my God. Dominic, it's Laura. All this time, was any of this real?
You know what? I don't think it matters whether any of it was real or not. It was all real to you.
Laura, my mom.
It's a miracle.
What the fuck? Dominic, she wore this every day.
Laura did?
Yeah, it's a locket. It's my parents. I hardly recognize them. They look our age. I've never seen my dad so young. Could you believe anything like this could ever happen?
You know what? I don't think it matters. It was all real to you, and from what I've heard, Laura was a fantastic woman.
I don't know what I think. I'll figure something out later. But can we keep this a secret between me and you for now? There's no way in hell anyone would believe this.
Secret safe with me.
Thanks.
Do you need a minute?
Yeah.
Stick around.
Just your
humor.
I know.
You know I'm picking on you because I like you.
start opening up again.
You want to start over?
Yeah, I'd like that. But there's someone I need to do that with first. Hey, Dad. It's Faith.
Someone, but we need to just point out two of our rookies for the show. We have Christy Fisher.